Dear learners, a warm welcome to the video lecture on classification of textile fibers, essential and desirable properties of textile fibers. Now let us discuss one by one. First of all, what is fiber? Fiber is defined as one of the delicate material and hair portion of the tissue of a plant or animal or other substance that are very small in diameter in relation to their length. The length to breadth ratio is minimum 1000:1. Then you can call it as a fiber. Then what do you mean by textile fiber? All fibers are not a textile fiber. The reason is the term textile fiber means a unit of matter which is capable of being spun into a yarn or made into a fabric by bonding or by interlacing in a variety of methods including weaving, knitting, braiding, felting, twisting or webbing. So these are all the technologies available to produce fabric and which is the basic structural elements of a textile products. A fiber that can be spun into a yarn or processed into a textile such as woven fabric or knitted fabric, lace, felt or non-woven material etc. by means of an appropriate interlacing methods is called as textile fiber. Textile fiber is a material mainly made from either natural or synthetic sources. This material will be converted into a textile yarn or fabric by means of woven, knitted, non-woven and carpets. Now let us discuss the classification of textile fiber. Basically, textile fibers are classified into two categories. One is natural fiber, the second one is man-made fiber. So under natural fiber, it is further classified into two categories. One is animal fiber, then second one is vegetable fiber. So example for animal fibers are wool, silk and then house hair, camel hair etc. Under vegetable fibers again it is further classified seed fibers, then bark fibers, leaf fibers, fruit fibers. The example for seed fiber is cotton and kapok. The example for bark fibers are flax, hemp, jute, kenaf, rami. The example for leaf fibers are abaca and sisal. The example for fruit fiber is coir. Now let us see the man-made fibers. See, man-made fibers are basically classified into two categories. One is semi-synthetic fiber and another one is fully synthetic fiber. Semi-synthetic fiber means the fibers, the raw materials we are taking from the natural source and we are further chemically modifying it and making into a yarn or filament. Those fibers are called as semi-synthetic fibers or you can call it as a regenerated fibers. Examples of regenerated fibers are cupromonium rayon, viscose rayon, polynosic rayon, acetate rayon, triacetate rayon. So many varieties of examples. Then coming to the synthetic fiber, purely it is produced by means of synthetic. That is, only chemicals we are using for the manufacturing of synthetic fibers. The right examples for synthetic fibers are polyester, nylon, polypropylene, polyurethane. These are all the examples for 100% synthetic fibers. Now, coming to the main topic, essential properties of a textile fiber. Please look at the slide. So, there are five essential properties of a textile fiber. The first one is length, second strength, third elasticity, fourth uniformity and fifth spinability. Now, let us discuss why these are all called as essential properties for a textile fiber. Now let us discuss the first property, length. The fiber must be long and fine enough. Yes, definitely. If the fiber is too long and the fiber is too fine, you can produce good quality of yarn with high tensile strength. Longer the fiber, finer will be the yarn. Okay. So the length varies from, in case of cotton fiber, the length varies from 1.5 cm to 4 cm. And in case of wool, 3 cm to 40 cm. Please look at the variation in length. Further, for blending, man-made filaments are cut into short length, then you can blend it with the cotton fiber or with the wool fiber. So, the length of the fiber should not be too much variation. If you are trying to blend, what will be the length variation between these two fibers? It may be 1 to 1.5 centimeter variation in length is allowable in case of blending of man-made fibers with natural fibers as well as with animal fibers. If it is too much variation, then it leads to difficult in case of processing. Okay, because the length parameter is going to play a major role in case of machinery settings, right from blow room to twisting, that is cone winding. So each and every settings in the machine, it depends upon the length of the fiber. Then this staple length should match with the length of the other component fiber used in blending. That's why I told you, when you are blending the fibers, the staple length should match with the length of the other component fibers. In general, or in a particular fiber, longer the fiber, the stronger will be the yarn, and similarly, the finer will be the yarn. Similarly, fine fibers are most suitable for producing soft, smooth, and uniform fabrics. Whereas coarser fibers will produce only, the fabric will be coarser and rough in nature. So how the coarser fiber will look? The diameter of the fiber is little bit very high. So the right example is, you can take the shirting material, it is finer in quality, whereas your bedsheet material, it is coarser in quality. So the fibers which is used for the manufacturing of bedsheets are coarser in nature. The fiber which is used for the manufacturing of shirt material, it is finer in nature. Then coming to the second property, strength. It is essential that the fabric should be durable enough. For durability, the fabric must be strong enough. The strength of the fabric is more influenced by the strength of the fiber. Yes. Also, strong fibers can withstand the tension while conversion into yarn or fabric, because the fiber is subjected to so much tension while making into yarn or making into a fabric. The strength indicates the resistance capability of the fiber without breaking when a force is applied on them. So the strength may be expressed either may be a tensile strength or the bending strength or bursting strength, etc., as per the direction of the application of the force. So you can name it either tensile strength, bending strength, bursting strength. It depends upon the end use of the material. So the strength should be strong enough for a textile fiber. So then only the yarn which is produced out of the fiber will be very strong. Then coming to the third property is elasticity. The third essential property of a textile fiber is elasticity. Elasticity is most important. It is the ability of the material to regain original shape after being deformed by the application of force. So the desirable feature of any type of fabric is that the fabric must not distort its shape during its application. This indicates that the material should have high elasticity. Higher elasticity indicates high recovery from deformation. The right example for elasticity is, suppose if a gymnastic person is wearing the dress materials. If the dress material is having high elastic property, what will happen? It will regain its original shape within a short period of time. Suppose if it not so, the sports person will not feel comfortable while performing that type of sports. So, the fiber should have high elastic in nature. Again, it depends upon the end use of the material. The coming to the next property, uniformity. Yes, uniformity of the staple is fourth essential property. It is essential that there should be limited variation in length and diameter between fiber to fiber. In other words, the fiber should be more uniform, which will ensure uniformity in the yarn as well as in the fabric. The next one is spinnability. Spinnability is the fifth essential property. It indicates that the individual fiber must be capable of being spun into a yarn and then a fabric with sufficient strength. For better spinnability, the fiber must have better cohesiveness. Cohesiveness in the sense, the fiber has to take up the twist while making into a yarn. Okay, so the above properties were termed as primary properties or essential properties, which are most common properties of popular natural fibers. Then coming to the desirable properties of a textile fiber. The first foremost desirable property of a textile fiber is moisture absorption. Moisture absorption means the absorption of water vapor from the atmosphere by a textile fiber when it is kept in open place. The moisture absorption capacity is expressed in terms of moisture content, which means the amount of moisture content in the textile fiber and its original weight of the fiber or its own woven dry weight of the material. Okay. So, the moisture absorption property is also a desirable property. Again, it depends upon the end use of the material. Okay. Suppose if a material is used as a dress material, definitely the fiber should have moisture absorption property. Suppose if the fiber is used in industrial applications like conveyor belt or tire cord, so where the moisture absorption property is not at all necessary for a textile fiber. Then coming to the next property, density. Density is nothing but the mass per unit volume or weight per unit volume. It is generally expressed in terms of grams per cubic centimeter. High density fibers will produce heavyweight fabric and vice versa. So, density is also a desirable property. Then the third one is color. Most natural fibers have same color. Silk is slightly yellowish color, whereas cotton is cream white or brown tint color. Most of the synthetic fibers are creamy in color. So, therefore, these colors has to be removed before the dyeing process. So, the process of removal of color, natural color present in the material is called bleaching. Okay. So, the process of removal of natural color present in the fiber is called bleaching process. The next property is luster. Luster means shining of a textile fiber. It is considered as an ornament rather than a necessary quality of a fiber. Yes, the luster need not be an important property for all type of fibers. So, again, the luster, it depends upon the end use of the material. The normal dresses doesn't need this type of luster property. Suppose if you are wearing a dress for functions like Diwali, Pongal or marriage, where the material needs shining property. The normal dresses doesn't need this type of luster property. So silk fiber and rayon fibers are more luster than other fibers. Then coming to the next property is static electrical resistance. Static electrical creates problem in the spinning process and other processing of textile fibers, especially with very low humidity condition. This problem is more severe in case of synthetic fibers because of low moisture absorption property. So static electrical property creates problem in the sewing process also. So the fiber should have static electrical resistance during the spinning process, weaving process and during the garment making process. Okay. So thank you for watching the video. Thank you one and all.